You recently bought a complex wireless device. It could be a US device or an international device. An international device is an SP8 or an SP8 Watt Edition, an SP6 or a Fit 5. Here you will find all the info you need to start with your wireless device. Welcome to the Complex Academy. Today I'm going to explain you everything about the Complex wireless device. I have a lot of viewers from the US, so I cover a little bit also of that Complex wireless USA. There's a difference between the US device and the international devices. And that's due to some FDA restrictions we are having in the US. We are limited in programs and limited in technology. So basically you have 10 programs in the US device and more programs for 30 or 40 programs in an international device. And if you take a look at MI technology, we haven't any MI technology in the US devices, which we have in that international device. It looks slightly different, but basically all the functionalities are mainly the same. Explanation of the buttons. First, let's talk about the buttons on the Complex wireless. Here on the side, you have the on and off button. Here you have four buttons for the four related modules or pods. So that are the channels. Then we have the outer ring and we have the inner ring. The inner ring is the enter. The outer ring is the navigation. So if you press up in the outer ring, you go up in the menu. Down, you go down in the menu. Left, you go back. And right, you go forward.
The wireless device settings.
Now we have switched on the device. If you switch on the device for the first time, then you have to connect the modules or the pods to the remote control. So first you see that we have a language selection. So I can press on the right side of the outer ring, you know that's forward, so I can press to a language I prefer. I can go to the left side by pressing on the outer side, again on the left, and I go to English. And I want to select that, so I press the middle button, and you see it's already turned up blue, that you know that you have to press there. And I can select the date, and I can set the time. Now you see, you will always come for the first time when you switch it on in that middle section. And that middle section, that are the programs. And you have different kind of programs which you can select. But you can also go up, then you go to your favorite programs. And those programs are my latest programs I used, or the most often I use them. And I can go down, and there you find the settings. So if I press on the right, I come in that screen of the settings. Here you have the language selection, but I already did, but I can change it if I want to. Then you have the MI auto range, the MI scan, the MI tense, the MI action. That are MI functions. They're only available in the international device and not in the US device, because we don't have MI technology in the US. I recommend first to look at my video about MI technology before you select those MI selections. The only one I want to activate in this situation in SP8, I would say the MI auto range, because that can be very helpful in your training program or recovery program, but you see it later on in selecting a program. So I switch off the MI scan, I switch on off the MI tense, and also the MI action. If I go lower, you see the cycles, and the cycle selection is the level selection. So in the US device you will see level selection. I switched that on. If you want to know more about that cycle selection, it's in my video of how to train with Compex part 1 and part 2. You can also select some power savings, I will do that also. And you can have the sound on and the contraction sound on. The difference is that the sound is the sound of the device. The sound of the contraction sound is for in a training program when the contraction starts. So he announces when the contraction starts, but you will see later in this video. I can go lower and set some times, pair a new model. So if you have a defect model and you have to pair a new one, or when the connection is gone of that model and you want to pair a new pair again, I will explain you in a video about some issues you can experience with the wireless device, but that's another video. Then I will explain you more about how to pair a new model. And you can reset to factory seconds set settings. So I go back in the general menu and go up to the programs. Now we switched on the US device. You see it's basically the same as the international device, only with some slightly different details. So I switch it on and you see we have the English language at front. It's the same as the international one. I can choose from also to a Spanish or to a French language. So you see we have more language selection in the international device, but basically it works the same. So I press on enter. I don't need to set times and dates, that's also different, but you are directly in the program settings. You see it's in the middle, it always starts in the middle in your programs. And you see here we have warm up and recovery and muscle building. In the international device we have more program sections, but basically warm up and recovery is recovery and massage, and muscle building it's more conditioning. So I can go up to press up to and go to favorites. I can go down and go to my settings. So let's go to the settings first. I press on the right to come in the screen. Here I can select the language. Here you can have the level selection. It's the same as the cycle selection. So if you want to know more about levels and cycles, go to the How to Train with Compex part 1 and 2, which is in this description below. We can also select power savings. You can put it always on. And here we have also the sound and the contraction sound. And the rest is basically the same.
Execute a program.
The device is set. I'm ready to go and to start to train with the Compex wireless device. First, I have to attach my electrodes. So I place some electrodes already here on my muscle. Then I have to connect a module. Here you have the module. You have, see that there is a button on the top, and on the bottom there is no button. So it doesn't matter if you connect it like this or like that. In our electrode placement advice, you can find sometimes that the button is down, but it doesn't matter if you do the button up or down. It doesn't have any effect on the function of the device. So I always place that button up because there is a V shape. You can see here there's a V shape in there. So if you hook it up like this, then it cannot fall down anymore. And my button is easier to reach, for example, if I'm attaching my calf muscles. So I hook up this by shifting it down on my electrode. And I shift it down and I always we'll tighten the cables a little bit. So you can roll it up and tighten the cables. So now I'm ready to go. I will attach another muscle to show you how it works in the device, to show that we have more options for more muscles. But I will attach the other muscle and then I will show you how to start to train with Compex in the Compex wireless. We are in the program selection. So if I press to the right to go to that selection or category, you see conditioning, recovery, pain management, rehab, and fitness. In the US device, we only have conditioning programs and recovery massage programs, but it's called differently, but you can see it in that part of the US. I will select conditioning because I want to execute a training program, and I will execute, I go down to resistance because that's a training program every device has. I press on the button to select, and there you see all the electrode placements. So I can scroll down to see those electrode placements and scroll up again. You don't need to select those electrode placements to start the program. It's just a book, it's just a reference to see where you have to place those electrodes. So I place those electrodes on my arms, so I won't select my arms, but I let it stay like this because I know the electrode placement. So I enter and come into the second section, and that's the cycle selection. If you didn't select the cycle selection, you switch it off in the settings, it's standard in cycle one. So I can choose cycle one, cycle two, if you're more experienced. So if you completed cycle one, and cycle three, if you want to have a more heavier training. How to do that? I explained that in How to Train with Compex part one and two. But I'm a first time user, so I select the first use. And then he says, how many channels do you want to select? So how many muscle groups do I have? So I will switch one on. I have two channels, so I have two muscle groups. So I switch on the two. And then you see that question mark that he says, do you have more? No, I don't have any more. So I press on the enter. And now you will see he's ready to go. So in this case, because I have the MI outer range on, you can see it here in the top. That's the MI outer range, MIAR. And he says, press up to start. Why is that MI outer range so important? So because when I now press up to start, he automatically will increase the intensity to an optimum level for me. And he does that in the recovery programs, in the warm-up and in the cooldown. So now he's searching on two channels to the most optimum intensity level. You can have a difference between this one and this one because he's searching automatically separately on those channels, but we will see what will happen later on. Now he has found the most optimum intensity level for my both separate muscles. And my warm-up is there. Sometimes he will say, I cannot find it, and he stops at 50. No worries about that. That's a safety in the machine. The only thing you need to know, I need to see twitches, so I need to see the muscle shake, and it must feel comfortable. Now I can adjust my intensity up or down. So I can press up, and you see that they both go up, and I can go down, and they can both go down. So you see that because I'm pressing up and down, he is now going to the manual settings. If I press this button, you see this channel will turn gray and this turn black. If I now go up, you see that only the black part, the left channel, will go up, and the right channel will stay in that intensity level. And if I press again, now he's selected again, and now I can go simultaneously up. That's basically the channel selection. I give you one trick. If I now press in the middle button, you see that the program will pause. And then you will see here, you see some arrows. So I can go back, I can go forward, or I can play. So if I press to the right side, I skip my warm-up and I'm directly in the training program. And you see that I have to execute 42 times those cycles, or head contraction relaxation phase, and then the program is finished. I can press again and then skip the training program, and you see that I've now finished the training program and go directly into cooldown. But I go back and I go to the training program because I want to show you how that works. So now I'm ready to go for that training program. So I can press up. It's all manually. So in the training itself, you don't have the MI outer range on. You see no MI outer range activated here in that corner. So I'm pressing up, and now I have to press up more and more and more to have a contraction. So I can do it slowly by pressing 1, 2, 3, 4. Very simple. Or I'm in the recovery mode. I press and hold, and then it goes much faster. So, you see, because I was now increasing my intensity, you didn't see you hear the beep very clearly, but you will hear how it works. So now my contraction phase ends. I'm in the relaxation phase, and listen what happens. So on the third beep, he starts to contract. So then you can anticipate on that, and that you can know when you can expect that contraction. Now if I increase, he will see, he will end, but he will stay there. And then now he goes. So if you are increasing at the end of the program, he will stay in that contraction. Okay, I will press the pause button. So now we will see that my maximum intensity was 108, and you see that my average intensity was 36. That are numbers you can use, for example, in the app of the Compex Coach, where you can fill in all your details about your intensity level. So to have the great performance index number. But I explained to you in how to train with Compex video. So if you want to know more about that, watch one of those videos, and they are in the link below. So I can skip now also my training. So I did my training, and I can go in the cool down. And if I do the cool down, it's the same as the warm up. If I completed that, then my program is completed. So that's basically how you execute a training program. If I now go out, then you see in my favorites directly this program resistance is added to that favorites tab. Let's go to the US device and see how that works. I go to the muscle building program, and I go to the next screen, and then you see four training programs, and also you see the resistance. So here you see we have less programs, but it works the same. So I go to the resistance program. Then you see that's book of all those electrode placements. You see here my electrode placement. You don't need to select this, so I let it stay here and then press. Then you have that cycle selection. It's the same as in the international device. So I select this first time use, and then I have to switch on the models. So this is model number one. I switch on model number two. He asks for more, but I don't have more modules to select. So I press on the enter, and then he's ready to go. You see, there is no MI function. We don't have any MI outer range, so I have to do it manually. So I press up, and if I press and hold, I go much faster. And now I have the intensity level for my muscles. The only important thing is for warm up is that you increase until visible shaking of the muscle, and it has to feel comfortable. Here you see the buttons you can switch on and off. So you know that you saw that in the international device, I had a difference between left and right. So if I switch this one off, and you see I let the blue one stay on and I increase intensity, then you see only that channel is increasing. So if they are both turn up blue in the screen and on the device itself, they can go simultaneous again. If I now press the middle button, you also enter in the pause mode. So I can go back, I can go forward, and let's go to the training. It looks really the same, only the colors are a little bit different. So let's start with that training. Press up to continue. So I will press up, and I will increase my intensity in the contraction phase. There you see it turns up blue on the top, where it's in the international is red, but it works the same again. Now I'm in the recovery phase. You hear the same beep, and the contraction starts. And I only need to do 42 contractions, the same as in the resistance program of the international. So the programs are the same, How it works is the same, only there is a slight difference between those devices. So if I stop the program again, then you see also here I have an average of 35. My max was also 35, so I can use that for the Compax app. The app isn't available yet in the US, but I think it will be soon available also for the US. So then you can also fill this in your performance index. So if I go to there, and so you press right and I go to the cooldown, and I can also go right again, and my program is complete. If I now press the button, you see also here in the favorites, you will see that the resistance program is on top because that's the last program I executed. So the training is done. Now we only have to disconnect our cables. We can do it by two ways. You know the V-shape, you can slide it down the V-shape, or we can pull it off. So if you slide it, you go along with the V-shape, and then you have to see, then you can slide it off easily. What I always do is that I put on my fingers here on the metal pin, and then I press a little bit, and then it's also easily to detach. So that's the way how you disconnect your cables from the electrodes. I have a few other tips, and you can find it right now, the last tips of this video.
Four tips for a wireless device.
Let me give you some tips about the Compax wireless device. If you executed the training and you detached all the modules and you want to put it away, you can put it away in the travel pouch, or you can put it away in the charger box. For the charger box, be gentle. So I always advise to roll up all those cables and then gently put it back in the charger box. You directly hear a click because there's a magnet in the charger box which will attach those modules in that box. So do not start to push, because otherwise you will damage those metal pins. If I put here the cable to the 220 or 110, for example, then you will see that everything will be charging. So you have to put in this remote control and some modules, and then you'll see in the screen that it's charging. And how does the charge look like? Here I have three modules or three pods in the box, and one I took out. So you see that on the top level, here you can see it, that he is charging. Then those other two are already full, and one is not in the box. So you see that very clearly that that's not attached, because that dot is gray. So that's how it looks like. In the top corner, you can see that also my remote control is charging in this case. For the US device, it looks the same. The top one is charging, two are already full, and one is out. And here in the top corner, you can see my remote control is charging. When you're on the travel and you fully charged your Compax device, your remote control and your modules, it's capable of executing 8 full sessions of Compax use or recovery or training programs. So that means that if you go away for a week or so, you only have to bring with you that remote control and some modules. If you want to take with you that charger box, I always recommend to put it separately in your luggage, and you want to separate those modules and that charger box. Don't put that models in that charger box and put it in your luggage, because when they throw with that luggage, you can see that sometimes those metal pins will break. So always put in that charger box in your luggage separately from your remote control and your modules. You can also pimp your wireless device. We have some specific faceplate stickers to pimp up your device. And last but not least, it's really important to upgrade your warranty. So you can have one extra year of warranty when you register your device with our website. On the backside here, you can find the serial number you register with that serial number and you get 1 year extra warranty. And that warranty is on the remote control, the four modules and the charger box. If you have a special edition, like an SP8 Watt edition, you have 3 years of extra warranty. So that can be very beneficial to register your Compax on our web store. These were all the tips for the wireless device. I hope to see you next time in a new video of the Compax Academy.